Last same, bro. As soon as we get finished with this interview, I'm gonna go get some food as well, because you
Thank you, my brother. Appreciate you.
So thank you guys so much for giving me some of your time. Absolutely love this series. So for both of you guys have both done a little bit of voice work beforehand. Yvonne, recently you with Velma. So can you guys talk about what it was like stepping into these roles and voicing these fleshed out characters like this? And Laz, you can go first. Or
Oh,
Yvonne, actually, you still drinking, Yvonne? Are you good? You
I'm
good?
good.
All right, Yvonne,
Thank
you go
you
first.
for giving me space. No, yes, I did Velma, and this, but this was different because this was like, this was the whole series, and she, my character has a little bit more meat and stake in the game on this series. But it was very similar in that it was just you in a booth and, people on a Zoom talking to you and telling you what to do. So, it was interesting to just be able to tap into that, especially coming from live action space where, and or even as a stand-up, you're able to play off of the audience. But it's like also you have to like trust that your castmates are going to bring it, and they are, you're familiar with their work, and so they're all fire, and so you don't want to be the weakest link. So it's that thing of like, okay, what's their energy going to be like? All right, well, what is my motivation? It's still the same thing, asking what is the motivation for this character and giving it to them.
And Laz, what about you, sir?
Yeah, I mean, it what Yvonne says is the challenging part, is because you're trying to imagine how she would say this line, or how she would play it, and at the same time, she's not playing Yvonne, she's playing a character, so she might change it. But for the most part, you trust. Like, once I heard that she was doing this project, I knew we were in good hands, and all the people involved, it's like you trust each other and each other's work. And when you're used to seeing certain people only do, amazing work on screen, you're like, okay, well, at least I know this part is gonna come out dope. And it did, it was new for me, and it was fun. It was a lot of fun, and I'm happy with what turned out. Thank
Likewise, my friend, you are phenomenal. And
you.
next time we'll have to do it live action.
Yes, absolutely.
My
Got to do a live action at some
Dad, the Bounty Hunter, the live action movie. Come on, Netflix, let's make it happen.
Broadway
Seriously, though.
play. I mean,
Yes.
Seriously, though. Like, I felt like the animation style, but just the story itself, it felt like a fully drawn out movie. So we could, if Netflix wants to do that, let's make it happen. But for both of you guys, especially you, Laz, we never get to really see a black family, especially black parenthood, in this type of space adventure thing. So can you talk about what that was like, just portraying this family and portraying especially the healthy co-parenting that you guys demonstrated? Like, what was that like? And stepping into that role.
did my best to tap into my peers who have, more than one child, who either have a co-parenting relationship or still, they're together raising their children. But everybody has a job, everybody has a role that they play within their structure, and I had to decide, okay, what would Terry's role be in this family structure? And in this family structure, he both feels guilty to his daughter because she needs him, and he knows that she needs him, but he also has this other thing that he's trying to do to provide for his family. There is also a sense of guilt with Tess, both in when he is with the kids, proving to her that he's a good father. Because he's really put the ball completely in her court, and it's unfair, and he knows that. And then with his son, this ball of joy, who sees him as a hero even before he finds out that he's a bounty hunter and how cool that job is, living up to that expectation. Black men have a lot of hats that we wear, and we try to do them all well. And we don't want to let anybody down. And I wanted to really show that on in this piece.
Amazing. And I thought you did. And Yvonne, with your character and with you just being the one of the funniest people I've seen on TV, can you just talk about what it was like improvising and bringing your, like, did you get to improv or bring some of your personality, more infusing it into the role, not just what was on the pages?
Tess is more, she's kind of like that fed up black woman. She's like, you got one more chance, Terry. Like, I want to believe in you, but bruh, you're making it really hard.
And so I brought more, not like the comedy part of me, but the jaded dater part of me. You know, it's, you know, when you go on these apps, and you just see like the foolishness that ensues in your dating life, and you're like, okay, I know this guy because this guy actually dated a friend of mine. Like, he was acting like he want to be responsible. Okay, I can tap into the essence of this Black woman with kids, even though I don't have kids when I've had relationships. And so that was my motivation, you know, but also trying to find the heart and not just make it like an angry Black woman. Like, we didn't do that trope, but it was the, like, I love you. I want this to work. I want this to work not only for us, but for our kids. I need your help, you know, and it's that vulnerability that she is able to bring out that gives it more layers.
Absolutely. Well, I'm getting a wrap up sign. Absolutely loving the series. And I thank you guys so much for giving me some of your time. Laz, you know, we're with the Geeks of Color, so, you know, we're ready for season 4 of The Boys. We cannot wait to see what y'all bring here. So I want to say thank you again so much for giving me some of your time. And I can't wait for more people to see this series when it drops.
Thank you so much, Dorian. Appreciate you.